Eugene V. Debs was a socialist, a revolutionary, and probably the most effective and popular leader that the American working class has ever had.
Debs for president!
Let the wealth of the nation belong to all the people and not just the millionaires.
Production for use, not for profit.
Workers, stand together!
We want Debs!
For 50 years, until his death in 1926, Eugene V. Debs devoted his life to the struggles of the American and international working class.
When workers, earning starvation wages on the railroads and in many other industries, needed help in organizing unions to defend their interest against the powerful corporations, Debs was there. He helped organize dozens of unions, including the American Railway Union, which at one time had a membership of 150,000.
When American workers needed a radical independent political party to stand up to the Democratic and Republican parties, which represented the interests of the capitalist class, Debs was there. He helped found the Socialist Party and ran for president on its ticket 5 times.
When American workers needed a revolutionary industrial union which refused to compromise with their employers, Debs was there. In 1905, he was one of the organizers of the Industrial Workers of the World, the powerful IWW.
During and after the First World War, when free speech was virtually abolished in this country, when radicals and anti-war activists were thrown into jail for expressing their opinions, when newspapers were censored and closed down by the government, when citizens were fired from their jobs because of their political views, Gene Debs was there. On numerous occasions, he put his life on the line by speaking out against the imperialist slaughter taking place in Europe.
In September 1918, when the court was about to sentence him to his jail sentence for opposing World War I, the 63-year-old Debs fixed his eyes upon the presiding judge and spoke his philosophy of life.
Your Honor, years ago I recognized my kinship with all living things, and I made up my mind that I was not one bit better than the meanest on earth. I said then and I say now that while there is a lower class, I am in it. While there is a criminal element, I am of it. And while there is a soul in prison, I am not free.
Unlike the capitalist politicians and labor leaders of his day, or this day, such as Samuel Gompers and the leadership of the American Federation of Labor, Eugene Debs was a man who had a vision that life on this planet could be something of beauty, joy, and cooperation. He refused to believe that the suffering that he saw all about him, the poverty, ignorance, war, and exploitation, was caused by God or nature.
He believed rather that much of human suffering was caused by an irrational and cruel economic system, capitalism, which functioned not to improve the quality of life for all the people, but simply to enrich the bank accounts of the few who owned and controlled the economy. Men such as John D. Rockefeller and J.P. Morgan. And Debs believed that there could be no fundamental solutions to the problems facing the vast majority of the people unless the capitalist system was overthrown and replaced by a socialist economy in which the working people took over the means of production and worked for themselves rather than for a boss.